So we're starting off right now. The lighting is terrible. Here we go. This is a little better. We've got Jody. We've got me. We're going to Norway. Yay! And we've got Alameda Ann. She brought us. You guys remember Alameda Ann, right? We're on our way now, and let's go get on an airplane. So we have landed in Sweden. We are here. We got our bags. We are set. We're just waiting for a train going to take us into town. We had a fun little adventure on the flight. One of our water bottles broke open and Jody's water bottle and absolutely destroyed her antidepressant medication. It was going to be exciting because it was going to be 2 weeks without it. Exciting in the, oh my God, what the hell, sense. Thankfully, Sweden had a pharmacy in the airport here, and they had her medication. It's fantastic. We are set with it. Huge shout out to both the Swedish healthcare system and the amazing pharmacist who guided us through everything right there. Mm-hmm. We're waiting in the train station in something that looks like it was carved out by dwarves. And it's beautiful. I'm not saying it's bad. But yeah, so here we are on our way to Sweden. In Sweden. Either way.
So we are all checked in to our Airbnb. I've got my Gordon's fisherman coat because despite trying on that North Face jacket that made me look like punk rock Michelin man, I decided to go with this one because instead of $100 whatever, this one was 12. So thanks Old Navy clearance. We're now making our way into downtown Sweden and we're gonna enjoy downtown Sweden. Yeah, downtown Sweden. God damn it, Daniel. Downtown Stockholm. And we're gonna enjoy some delicious foods. Let's do this.
So we got a charcuterie plate to start out with. We've got this grilled cheese, which is straight up cheese in a bowl, heated up, with is delicious. 5 different types of salami. We got salami picante, fennel sausage. This one's with red wine, classic Tuscan, and wild boar, which actually I have yet to get it. Let's get in on this. Pretty good. And yeah, this is just all amazing. We've also got this awesome sausage on a bun. We found out the hot dogs are huge here, but this is considerably better than a hot dog. So tasty. Absolutely worth it right here. So good.
We just got out of the Hairy Pig Deli, and now we're at a little chocolate shop, and we're going to try this out right now. So far, it looks delicious.
This is just like... This is served. We are in Gamlestaden, which is the centralmost of the islands of Stockholm, and it is very old as far as the architecture. It even still has cobblestone streets. We're going to check out a cafe near where we were last night, but we can also see things better, which is why we're doing this walkthrough during the day. So there's that. Great thing about this island is also home to the Nobel Museum, as well as the, it's like the Royal Palace? Yeah, it's basically the Royal Palace of Stockholm. So we'll take a look at that.
Thank you.
So, I don't know if you knew this about Sweden, but it gets cold. We are very chilly. It is very windy today. It's possibly the coldest day in Sweden of our trip right now, but that's okay. We just had an amazing breakfast. So good. Quiche is amazing here. Who knew? It was really like lunch. Yeah, Jody's right. We're heading into the Vasa Museet right now, which is a museum featuring like a really old recreation of a ship that sank on its maiden voyage. That's never happened before, right?
This thing is enormous and didn't even get out of the harbor before it sank. But here's a better view of the Vasa. It was once big, hard, and full of seamen.
So it is a travel day for us. We are now on our way from Stockholm to Sweden. Oh, you look gorgeous. We are on our way from Stockholm to Oslo. It is snowing delightfully and we are inside for, oh, it's fine, don't worry about it. Anyway, we're taking the train across countries right now from Sweden to Norway and it's gonna be fun. Beautiful view from our Airbnb definitely made it worth it when it was out of the way to get there. Except for when it was definitely not worth it to get up there. It was also at this point during the videos that I decided that I was going to give voiceover work for a day in the life a try. I really hope it's working out. Well, good morning, internet. We're spending our first full day in Norway. We are in Oslo, capital, and we are on our way to the historic museum, where there are plenty of antiquities and other tours. There's so much room for antiquities. Now we're making our way up there through so many beautiful old buildings that are now home to Hard Rock cafes and Burger Kings and McDonald's, yeah. But it's gorgeous architecture, which has been the entire trip so far. All these old buildings have been around forever. You think of like old in the United States sense, and it's like, oh wow, this has been around since the 1600s. Europe's like, yeah, that's cute. So we're now a little further south of Oslo on its very own peninsula. I call it Viking Island, but it's where the Viking Ship Museum is. Cue up the Skyrim music. And it's a flight that's just so out of the airport that we got to board from outside the plane. I've not done this since before the new millennium. That's how long it's been. So you know those things they say about guys in cold weather? It's true. We are now in surprisingly warm Tromso. It is Within, I guess it's within the Arctic Circle, because it's a circle rather than a line. You think of above, but it's within. We're within the Arctic Circle. I'll probably cut out all of that. We're just touring around. There's a beautiful cathedral right there, positioned with its clock tower so that it looks like it's out of Back to the Future. We're gonna go see if we can save the clock tower. In the meantime, we're looking around, and a little bit, we're actually going on a brewery tour, which is gonna be pretty fun. Jody, you ready for that? Okay, so right now we're going on the Tromso beer safari. We're hitting up two pubs, cafe, and trying 10 different beers. It's gonna be delicious, and we'll see how long we last through this tour.
Please don't fall.
So we're at the tail end of the beer tour. We're already three down, and we've got these seven that we've got to polish as well. Whole table is ready for this, and we're gonna get this going.
We just finished with the brewery tour. We're meeting with all of our brand new friends. We've got so many new friends on this one. That's the thing about brewery tours, is you always make new friends. We're at a bar that is basically AFK back in San Jose. We're enjoying this so much. So many like video game themed stuff, and we're gonna enjoy this so well.
California has a good environment for growing vegetables, so we have a lot of...
So good morning. It's our first full day, first and really only full day in Tromso. It's coming down a little bit. I don't know why people don't come here more often. It's gorgeous. Actually, we don't get a lot of the snow. It's so fantastic. This is the best ever. We're going to go back to the hotel, change for a second, and then head out and figure some stuff to do. Mostly breweries and pubs. Let's get...
Beers and pubs.
Yeah, we'll be drinking. We're at Polaria, which is a little aquarium and everything, but they have seal feeding going on, and we're going to see if these guys eat like Ripley. So I think I mentioned this earlier, hot dogs are the big thing in Stockholm and Norway. We're all the way up in Tromso right now still, and we're at what's called the rocket ship. Jody has her, yours is just the pulse?
Meatland.
Which is a classic pork sausage. I have the rocket pulse. It is reindeer and beef, and I'm looking forward to this. And it's great, they do just like simple ingredients for mix-ins. They gave us the guide on how to do it, and we're gonna try it right now. I'm pretty sure it's delicious as apple. Let's give it a, how's yours? You're going to town.
Okay.
No, it's okay? Mm-hmm. Whoa. I'm sorry you had to see that. So reindeer hot dog is good. Reindeer and beef is finger blitzing good. I think this is a go. So yeah, if you go to Tromso, come up to the rocket ship. All right, so now we're making our way over to the Mac Brewery, which is the big local brewery. We're gonna take a quick tour of that place, and there's gonna be a nice little bar afterwards.
So you can actually see here, they're actually playing music all the time on the room. So yeah, they listen to rock music, and of course they have something called, some playing kids music as well, because we have one kids band called Knuts or the Vixen that is playing kids music for grown-ups. So it's like a grown-up humor in the music, and it's very fun. This door, I'm mixing the yeast, I just close it again, and let the yeast just over. And now you can actually hear here, they're actually eating. And this is called a pressure. I have no idea what it's called. It's very technical. So it's just, this is the easting house.
We found our friends from our beer tour last night. We're out here, we're at O'Hallen's. I'm still not saying it correctly. Did I get it that time? That's the closest I've gotten. First time I saw it, I thought it was O'Halloran's. So that tells you what it's been like. But we joined up, we met up with them. They got their sweaters, I got my sweater. Jody's enjoying her beers. We're having a great time, so skull. So we're now back in Oslo. As you can see, my hair is super flat from being under a hat for several days. We're now walking through the botanical gardens, which as you can see are lovely and very full of foliage at the moment. Right now, we're gonna make our way over and have a little cafe because we are hungry from our trip. It's just a little after lunchtime. Yeah, and then we'll find some other stuff. The Edvard Munch's Museum is around here. I'm taking guesses that that's how you pronounce it.
Edvard Munch.
He is the man who painted The Scream. The Scream is not in this museum, but we will try and see it at the National Gallery later. In the meantime though, enjoy. B-roll.
yum.
So we did the Munch Museum, which didn't feature a lot on him. It showed all of his works, but was confusing aft. Now we were instead over at Vigeland, which is a huge statue park, and we're gonna take in all of this. Right off the bat, it's all very beautiful, and let's see how it looks.
The Vigeland Open Air Museum is definitely difficult for a lot of people to take in, but with its nude models, personally, I think it's pretty nuts.
Hi, I'm Daniel. I can't do anything right. We're at a cafe right now, just getting some coffee before we step back out. That's what you do at a cafe. There was a little bird in here a second ago. I tried to open the door to let it out. It flew out, but another bird flew in, because of course it did. So in trying to make up for that, I went again and held the door open and let that bird out. Instead, the first bird flew back in. There are now two birds in this cafe. Just Daniel things.
After Oslo, we found ourselves in Bergen, which is on the upper western coast of Norway. The city itself shared a lot of similarities to San Francisco, but in a much better way than Oslo did. It also had many similarities to Boston in its older architecture, and its rainy weather that we encountered in many points made it feel like Seattle at times. All in all, though, it was probably one of the most beautiful cities we encountered on the entire trip. The oldest part of the city, Bryggen, was an example of what life had been like back in the old fishing era of the city, really when Bryggen was at its highest point. And tucked away in the back streets of Bryggen was the Theta Group's hiding spot, a resistance group that fought against the Nazis during World War II. The city of Bergen has done a marvelous job of maintaining all of the old buildings and making sure that they can exist for future generations to see. Speaking of sea, we took to it the next day on a ferry that took us out to the fjords. The picturesque landscape was a highlight of the trip and made even more so beautiful by the adventures that we got to have on the tour itself. You know what? Let's add some nice music to this. Fjord's natural waterfalls provided an excellent spring of water and, as well, the most exciting moment of our trip as we got to go right up to the waterfall and sample some of the water itself. It was thrilling, especially as we thought we were about to crash into it, and, well, we did. Back inside the cabin, we tried some of the water itself, and to quote one of the greatest films of all time, it was some high-quality H2O. Quite possibly some of the crispest water we've ever tasted. You never think about tasting water, but, well, there it was. And then, speaking of tasting, we made our way back into Bergen to try some more hot dogs, this time each of us trying some reindeer. By each of us, I mean just me. And as if the views from the fjords weren't enough, we then proceeded to the top of the mountain overlooking Bergen for one of the most majestic views of the city available to us. Despite the wind and the rain, we were still able to take in all the beauty that Bergen had to offer us. And well above the city, we were also able to take in a short hike, where we did manage to discover a little troll area. Trolls, of course, being a big part of Norwegian mythology. And don't get me wrong, while it was cool to see all of the trolls and all of the statues made out of them, well, they were certainly creepy af. With our final day in a pork town, we figured it would be a mistake to not check out the local fishery, where we did see plenty of the fishes and try some of them as well, including whale meat. And of course, I did this. Back to Stockholm.
So we're on the final day, as you can tell by how flat my hair has become, and we are back in probably the best town on the trip, Stockholm, ladies and gentlemen, enjoying ourselves. She knows it. She just gave us a thumbs up. This lady knows. Stockholm number one. We're on our way to a little cafe we didn't get a chance to stop into on the first time. We're going to try it. It looked delightful. The Girl Ska. So let's go have some tasty treats. If not, there was another place that looked also awesome. Hey, you too. So the pastries were delicious. As I mentioned before, we're back in Stockholm, which is the capital of Sweden. And if you're in Sweden, there's one museum that you, of course, have to go to by law. Mamma mia, here I go again. My, how can I resist you? Mamma mia, does it show again? My, just how much I missed you. Yeah, something broke. Wait, what the hell? I don't think you're Native American, sir.